Are you tired of doom scrolling about climate change? Are you struggling to grow food and are ready for some real solutions? Join me as we explore the groundbreaking insights of Gabe Brown, Joel Salatin, and Colin Seis, pioneers in regenerative farming and gardening. While many people recommend using regenerative practices to build healthy soil and fight against pests and weeds, these thought leaders delve deeper, disclosing the fundamental reason why we have problems growing food. Hi, I'm Dr. Wendy Seabrook from Learning from Nature. Imagine a world where we grow food in ways that not only feed us, but also help heal the planet. That's what Gabe Brown, Joel Salatin, and Colin Seis have realized is possible. You'll hear from these farming legends in a moment, but first, I want to give you the heads up on why their perspective is so valuable for streamlining how we get our farms and gardens into a good enough condition to grow food effectively and help heal the planet. The challenge is we've got to switch our focus. By applying regenerative practices like don't disturb the soil, by ploughing and digging, keep the soil surface covered, keep living roots in the soil, and we usually do this sort of growing things like cover crops, grow a diverse range of crops, and integrate in livestock. All of these regenerative principles can help us improve issues like low carbon and nutrient levels in our soil, pest damage and poor crop pollination. But these aren't the root cause for our problems with growing food. They are simply the symptoms of growing food in poorly functioning ecosystems. As Joel, Colin, and Gabe have recognized, we need to regenerate our ecosystems. Over to them now, and then we'll have a look at the benefits of using this ecological approach.
Many people ask, well, what is the definition of regenerative agriculture? In my mind, regenerative agriculture is farming and ranching in synchrony with nature to repair, rebuild, revitalize, and restore ecosystem function, beginning with all life in the soil, moving to all life above the soil.
People look at me and they say, you know, how'd you get so creative? I said, look, I'm not that creative. I just step back and look and say, how does this work? How does the world work? How does the ecosystem work?
The problem is our farm ecosystems and soil ecosystems are broken. Now, no one talks about farming about ecosystems, but if you think about it, our farms, and especially soils, but our farms used to and should function as ecosystems, because if they function as ecosystems, then old Mother Nature's fixing our problems for us, fixing the insect attack, fixing crop diseases, fixing many of our problems that we get in agriculture can and used to be done by natural systems. Can we still do that? Yeah, we can.
Joel, Colin, and Gabe have realized that by focusing our efforts and resources on repairing the ecosystems, the ecological systems within our vegetable gardens and our orchards and fields, we tackle the root cause for our problems with growing food. We streamline getting our farms and gardens to the point where we grow food more effectively and future-proof them against climate change. Realizing this, we choose regenerative practices primarily to repair our ecosystems rather than trying to continuously fix the symptoms of dysfunctional ecosystems. So with functioning ecosystems, our crops and livestock can access the nutrients they require, relying on the nutrient recycling system in our soil, rather than on us continuously applying fertilizers, compost, and other external inputs. With functioning ecosystems, we create energy-efficient food production systems, improving crop yields and the health and productivity of our animals. And lastly, with functioning ecosystems, we naturally increase water availability to our crops, reducing our water bills and reliance on irrigation. Here's a practical example. Typically, we routinely spread mulch and compost to increase our soil's carbon and organic matter levels. But what if we ask ourselves, what would be the best way for me to improve my soil ecosystem? Then we choose regenerative practices that achieve much more than improving our soil's carbon and organic matter levels. And we benefit from all of the ecological services soils with functioning ecosystems provide. Plus, our task becomes a lot easier because all we need do is manage our vegetable gardens, orchards and fields so that our soil community has enough resources to provide all these ecological services. I explain how here. With probably over 40% of the Earth's land surface now farms and gardens, imagine the contribution that growing food with functioning ecosystems will make to the health of our planet. Are you ready to be part of the solution? Well, watch these and other videos, you know, featuring Joel, Colin and Gabe. See the links in the description below. But also use our handbooks for step-by-step guidance on using this world-changing ecological approach.